It's like the night before the game, you can't sleep, eat. It takes so much out of you to think about anything other than the game. The game has already consumed your mind, hijacked your brain to the point it's all you think about, man. And all that preparation through sacrifice and blood, sweat, and tears. I'm talking from Sunday up until then, it's like I'm preparing for war. After still carrying the scars and pains from last week's war. And let's not forget about last week's war, young one. The mistakes you made and how you vowed to assure you don't make those same mistakes this war. Not only because you're destined for greatness, but because last week's war, we came up short. Like my granddaddy used to say, man, football is organized war on a grassy highway. And in order to get from one end zone to another, I'm talking in order to get from one end zone to another, man, I just want you to answer one question, man. As you sat in the locker room, dog, and as you strapped up, what was your last prayer, man? Did you pray for victory? As you sat in the locker room and you strapped up, man, what was the last thing you looked your dogs in the eyes and said, man? I don't know about you, man, but I'm looking every one of my dogs in the eyes, man. I'm telling my dogs, man, I want that same energy y'all gave me Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, man. I'm looking for that same energy y'all gave me all week, man. We going to war, man. And this ain't no war. We gonna fight alone, man. I need you and you need me. You gonna ride for me? I need you, man. You gonna ride for me?
Football.
It's probably going to practice and annoying Coach Tillard every day.
AJ, what are you going to miss most about football?
Summer practices and conditioning with the boys.
We about to turn it on.
Yeah.
gonna miss most about football?
I'm gonna miss my teammates, my coaches, all the motivation we get on every single day, and the practices.
And seeing you.
Favorite memory, Carson, from this year?
I gotta say, my favorite memory is back at Wingate. We're running a drill, and Alex Ucala said, "Take that freshman's cleats, get him off the field." And the next ball he got, hit him on the head. Next thing I know, he was on the ground.
This year.
My favorite memory is sleeping in the locker room with all my teammates at 3 in the morning.
Favorite memory from this year?
My favorite memory was doing backwards bear crawls up the hill with Coach Enlow.
Nice. Best cab impression.
All right. Michigan State versus App State, 2007. All right. I wasn't even a starter. I was practice squad, but the practice squad makes the team. I got my ring. I don't know about you all, but I got my ring.
Tell me what football has meant to you this year.
Football has meant to me a lot. It's like a brotherhood in the family.
Sabres having a good year, up 7-0 early. Cuthbertson has the answer. AJ Colombo fires to Matthew Grant for the score.
What are you going to miss most about football, Matthew?
I'm just going to miss going out on the field every single day with my friends. They're making me laugh like they are right now.
Are y'all ready? Are y'all ready? What? Yeah. Y'all ready to play some football? Let me know, I'm about to break this thing up. Let's go.
your favorite memory of football this season?
My favorite memory would probably be enjoying team camp and being able to sit down and eat meals with the team and just laugh and talk.
And everybody knows somebody that knows something about it. And I want answers now. Who, what, where, when, why? See, a lot of dudes like to act the fool. Now I'm getting on live, but that ain't my style. Know who he gon' get and what he gon' do. Run up on me if you want to. Hot damn pressing his homies. He's done up in front of his mama. I'll mop up the floor with him. And I can get the door and let the fofo get him. I got fools that'll go get him. That's for him and the crew and the dudes that run with him.
So what's Cav say to motivate you?
Embrace the suck. Say we win.
Let me know, let me know. I'm about to break this thing up.
Gotta spit it for the murderers and the killers and the thugsters. They be f***ing up the ballers and the dealers and the hustlers. Got me coming at you bogus in the VI while they bumping Lil' Jon. I'm a rusher. It's a psycho twister from Chicago. Rolling with the Miami, then a crusher. We already be looking for drama. If a n***a try to get into a witness, then we gotta get him. Feeling free from the torture that could never be cured. I'm feeling selling. I'm telling you, trick up in and steal him. Got me swinging Chrissy and Hennessy bottles in the club. I'm a thug, homies going for the Skrilla. Don't get it twisted with that overnight celebrity. You better be scared of me in my city, I'm a killer.
What's your favorite memory of the season?
It was a game when we played in Barkley, our first game. Their quarterback threw the ball to the person that I was guarding, and I caught an interception, and I got all hyped, and turns to find out that we had a flag, and it came back, and it didn't really count on my stat. Yeah.
Don't pretend to be me, I'm strictly for the thugs. I'm for the street and straight out the hood. My M.O. is ghetto and I don't even need to cap for you bunch of cats. I'm straight out the county day, real fire in my head. You ever come south for the ball, I first must own, you're gonna get slaughtered.
Let's go! If you want it, you can get it, let me know, let me know. I'm about to break this thing up, let's go!
To you?
Playing football has meant like kind of a family away from my own family, just because I've moved around everywhere. The friends that I've once had have not been there before, and it's just like my time to get away and have fun.
What's your funniest memory from the team?
The funniest memory when I was at practice is when I caught a slant and I broke Dawson Pruitt's ankles.
When I feel that chill, smell that fresh cut grass, I'm back in my helmet, cleats and shoulder pads, standing in the huddle, listening to the call. Fans going crazy for the boys of fall. They didn't let just anybody in that club.
Dawson, what's your favorite memory of the year?
My favorite memory from this year has got to be Wingate with my teammates.
To get to wear those game day jerseys down the hall. The kings of the school, man. Where the boys are fall. Well, let's turn and face the stars and stripes. It's fighting back them butterflies. It's calling in the air all around. Yes, sir, we want the ball. And it's knocking heads and tongues.
All right, Jack, give me your best Cav impression.
All right, bring it up on me. On me. All right, do you guys even care? I swear, it's like you don't even care. You don't care enough. We've gotten that taste of air. Imagine how good that first breath is gonna feel. Imagine, you gotta find that inch. I got my ring. I know how championships are won. I know how they're won. App State, Michigan, 2007. I know how to win. We're not there yet.
So what was your favorite part of camp?
Probably the coaching impressions and the try not to smile challenge. And when Chibuzo took his shirt off and growled at Vincent and then started singing as terribly as humanly possible.
And will always think they know it all. Young girls will dream about the boys will fall. Well, it's turn and face the stars and stripes. It's batting back them butterflies. It's calling in the air around. Yes, sir, we want the ball.
What are you going to miss most about football?
Just the whole football family, you know, going out to practice and, you know, having fun.
When your back's against the wall, you mess with one man, you got a soul.
Most about football?
Just gonna miss being around my boys and hanging out all the time.
In the air all around, yes sir, we want the ball. Knocking heads and talking trash. It's slinging mud and dirt and grass. It's I got your number, I got your back. When your back's against the wall, you mess with one man, you got a soul. Boys are fun.
So what's the best part of being a senior on the team, Jack?
The best part of being a senior on the team is being able to boss around the underclass.
Yeah.
Yeah, so when I was in high school, before we played one of the biggest games of the year, my head coach, the late Randy Ledford, sat us down in the locker room and he started pacing back and forth quietly, didn't say a word. You know, we're all looking at each other like, what the heck is going on? Like, dude was quiet. Then he stopped and he looked our captain right in the eye and asked one question, one simple question. He asked him, why do you play the game of football? Captain quickly responded. He said, we play the game because we love it. And our coach immediately fired back a question. He asked him, why do you love this game? The player sat quietly for a moment, and before he could answer, coach looked at the group and said, you love the game because of each other. You love it because of the brotherhood. It's what happens between the games and practices that makes football so special. You build bonds with people, unbreakable bonds, because you go to war together. When you make a play, we all make a play. When you miss a tackle or miss a block, we all suffer. Football is a game of passion, a game of heart. But above all else, it's a game of brothers. And that didn't really resonate with me until the end of the game. We lost in overtime on the goal line. And the bus ride back was silent, you know, except for a few occasional sniffles. Some tears, you know, hitting the floor. But it was in that silence that I realized that no matter the outcome, we were brothers. We win and lose as a team. Together. So, next time you step out on that field, play for your brothers. Play for the men beside you. Because in the end, y'all will be on the bus together regardless.
My Cuddy boys, what's good? Coach Rowe here checking in. Hey, super proud of y'all boys. Y'all are stretching the limit, proving the world wrong. Still in the season, man. Hey, Banquet was here, but the season ain't over yet, man. I'm super proud of y'all. Hey, keep pushing, going crazy. My day ones, man. Hey, I call y'all my day ones. That Cuddy senior group, y'all a special group to me. Because without y'all, man, I could easily say it wouldn't be any Row Pro, man. Row Pro wouldn't be where it's at without y'all. Y'all super influenced and pushed this whole thing. Helped me find my passion and what I wanted to do in life, man. I appreciate you guys and everything y'all done for me. And just a quick word of wisdom. Make sure you're taking whatever you're learning from the game, whether you're going to the next level to play where you want to play or you're not playing at all, man. Just understand that the values and things that you can learn through sports is so much bigger than just the sport itself, man. It's no doubt that every single one of y'all, I feel like, will be successful in life and whatever you choose to do, man, as long as you apply the same mentality that you're applying to the game right now, man. I love y'all. Hey, salute. Keep pushing, man. Keep proving the world wrong, man. I'll see y'all on Friday.
Seniors, man, 4 years, that went fast. I can't believe it. I still remember a lot of you guys from middle school. You guys have done a great job over the last 4 years committing to this program, helping to build this program to what it is, committed to one another in this community. So proud to be your coach. So proud of each one of you. I know all of you will go on to do great things in life, and I can't wait to see. If I can ever do anything for you, my door will always be open. I love you guys, and best of luck.
All right, my advice for the boys for life after graduation is find something you enjoy doing and do it. Whether it's college, or if you want to go straight to work, or military, whatever it is, make sure you enjoy doing it. And anytime you wake up in the morning, you will never have a hard time.
What's up, seniors? I just want to say I'm extremely proud of you guys. I know I haven't been here very long, and just want to say that in my time being here, being around you guys, I'm super proud of the men you become, the things that you've done for this program, and I know that each of you are going to be great in whatever you do moving forward. All I'm going to say is, advice wise, is just all the little things that you've learned, from the extra punishments to the close games of either coming out on top or not coming out on top. Use those as life lessons, right? Use those as, understanding situations where you hit adversity. You know how to figure it out. You know how to fight adversity. You know how to overcome. But that's all I got, man. Just congratulations. I'm proud of you guys, and can't wait to see how you guys turn out.
Best of luck to you and your future endeavors. If you've gained anything from playing the sport of football, is just understanding that there's always going to be something that's coming your way, and there's always a way to get through the adversity. Love you guys.
So during my time as a player and a coach, there's one thing that I learned through football, among other things in my life, but I did learn this in football, and I hope that you guys learned it too, and that is how to overcome adversity. So what I mean by that is, if you want to do something in life, right, you need to learn how the process of success works, right? That is to first, you need to study whatever it is you're going to do, learn about everything you can, make a plan, then execute that plan, and then either you're successful or you're not, right? If you're not successful, if you are successful, either way, you need to reevaluate what it is that you just did, and if it was successful, how do you make it better? If it was not successful, how can I be successful with it, right? And then ask yourself, did you do your best? Every time you need to ask yourself, did I do my best, right? And then repeat that process, and eventually you're going to find success. So, and the other part of that is learning how to do it with others. So to be part of a team, because sometimes you're going to follow, sometimes you're going to lead, right? But you need to be successful in a team environment, especially once you go out and get a real job. So best of luck, boys.
Hey guys, it's Coach Walker. I just wanted to wish you the very best, and my advice is to do what makes you happy in life, no matter what, and where that path leads you, do what's going to make you happy. And I hope that football has, taught you how to be a great teammate, taught you how to be a good person, and how to have a great work ethic. And just remember, if you give your best effort in everything you attempt at life, you're going to be very successful. And I wish you guys all the best, and, if you ever need anything, you know how to reach out to me. Thank you.
My guys,
First of all, let me just say I love you guys. I can say that because I've been with you from the start, most of you. From Booze on Tape playing flag football to coaching you guys in eighth grade to now coaching you guys in your senior year. Can't wait to see what the future brings for you guys as you become husbands, fathers, and maybe even coaches someday. That being said, remember what I've always told you since eighth grade. The Bill Parcells quote. Blame no one. Expect nothing. Do something. Love you guys. You keep rocking and doing what you're doing. Let's take it all the way in the playoffs, and I'll talk to you soon. Love you guys. Bye.
Hey, guys. It's Coach Cavanaugh. Just want to say congratulations. I know that at this point of your career, you're probably about sick and tired of hearing my voice, so I won't be long, but just want to give you guys some encouragement moving forward with the rest of your lives. Be proud of what you've done here. I can't tell you how proud I am of you and all that you've done and accomplished. You've really put a huge footprint on the school and this program, and everything we do from here on out is going to have a lot to do with you. As you move forward in life, I encourage you to have strong convictions and to really stick to those and be willing to fight for anything, be willing to fight for what you care about and for who you are. Determine what really matters to you. And at the end of the day, once you decide what those things are, live up to them and have convictions in everything you do and be relentless in staying up for those values. I just encourage you guys to really take what you've learned from us and each other and this great football family and use those tools to become greater men and brothers and eventually husbands and fathers. And I can't wait to keep up with you. I can't wait to see what this awesome future has in store for you as you move on to better things and bigger things. Enjoy life, and you'll always have a phone call away from me. Always have something here at Cuthbertson or wherever any of your coaches are at that you can come and visit anytime or reach out to with any questions or anything like that, guys. We'll always be here for you. We'll always be family. I love you all very much, and go Cavs.
The end of the year is here, and you made it this far. There were good times and there were bad times, but yet you are still here. You made it this far because something kept you going. Something kept you believing. Something helped you to understand that the fight was not over yet. This is the year that is soon to come to a close. Weaknesses, you had to experience things that no one can understand. But you are the one that has to be responsible to go through it. You were put on your back, and you probably thought that you didn't have the ability to come back, but you did. Sometimes you may hear people's circumstances, regardless of heartaches and pains, regardless of the joys, regardless of the sorrows, you made it. You made it because there was purpose there. Purpose doesn't lie. It always, always tells the truth. You just got to understand.